Hello YouTube, Psycho Fox here. You're looking at Atari 2600 Junior. This is my latest console purchase. I've owned one of these in the past and sold it a long time ago. And the main reason why I bought this is because I just wanted something to tinker with. It was about £5 off eBay. The other reason I bought it was you could just about make out in the pictures. It's got its plastic film over the metal bezel there, still in place. If you can see the sort of bubbling there of the Atari logo. So that's going to be quite satisfying to pull off when it's all finished. Yeah, so it's in pretty good cosmetic condition. It's missing one of the tabs off the cartridge port there, but that can be easily fixed just by either sticking on a piece of plastic or a screw from beneath and just having the thread poking up. All the ports are there, power ports not being pushed inside. So yeah, it's looking good. Came with a joystick which has got the old obligatory chew marks on the top by dog or child, I don't know. So it's worth it for that, because they're worth about 15 quid if you sell them separately. So yeah, it's worth it for that. Third party power supply. I have tested this. This is the only part I've tested at the moment, and the light doesn't work, but it is outputting the correct voltage. So all I've done is give this a little baby wipe down. It just had a bit of yellowy brown dirt on it. It's come up quite nice. So what I'm going to do next is open it up. I just said in the auction untested, so you never know. It could actually be that. It could work fine. So yeah, let's have a look under the hood. Okay, so I've took all the screws out. There's five screws holding this together, and it just opens up from this side. Yeah, thanks for that. There's a ribbon cable on this side. Just got to be a bit careful not to tear out. So yeah, everything at first glance looks okay. There's nothing missing. It's actually pretty clean. So I think what I'll do is I'll just give, I might take the board out and just wash the bottom half of the casing and just give it a little bit of a clean with isopropyl. Might need to have a look under the shielding here as well. But on the whole, not too bad inside. So I'll get that all cleaned up and then we'll put it back together and get it tested. Okay, so I've just took the board out of the bottom section here. I'm just giving it a little baby wipe. As you can see, it's got a bit of dirt in here, but if it was really, really bad, I might think about, you know, putting it in the bath and blasting it with a bit of hot water from the shower attachment. But no, it's not too bad. So the board's just got a bit of dust on it, so I think I'll just give it a little clean with isopropyl. I don't think I'm going to remove the metal shielding, not unless there's any great need to investigate further if the thing doesn't work or anything like that. So yeah, there's a bit of dirt in there, but nothing to really worry about. The inside of this little going over. So yeah, there's a little strip that the buttons make contact with, and there's the sliders on the other side. So yeah, quite a nice simple little console this. Right, so let's get the isopropyl and give the board a little going over. Okay, so all I'm doing is dipping a bit of isopropyl on the end of a cotton bud or Q-tip, and I'm just going over the board just to get all the gunk and clumps of dust off it. It's actually not too bad. I mean, there's a bit of dirt there, but that's to be expected. I mean, this thing is from 1983. The screws on the case did actually feel a bit You know, when you open something up and the screws aren't quite as tight as you might hope. So I wonder if someone has actually been in here before. But we'll see when we get it tested. As I'm recording this, I don't actually have a game to test it with, but I have got Pole Position on its way to me. So after I finish this cleaning, I will cut to a point in time when Pole Position has arrived. And I chose Pole Position because it was cheap, I'll be honest. It was only a few quid. And it's also a good game. And one that if I was keeping the system, which I'm not sure if I am, but if I was, it's definitely one I would pick up. So I sort of went down that route to cover all bases. So you just got all that. Little tops of these connectors a little going over. So yeah, like I said, it's not too bad. Now another good idea is to clean the cartridge port. Let's just see if I can reach under this shielding a bit. That's not. So right. Let's see if we can get this not too bad. Get this cartridge port cleaned. Right, so what I've got here is I've got a baby wipe, I've wrung the moisture out of it, I've dipped it in some isopropyl, and I've wrapped it around a credit card. So I'm just going to very gently use the corner, like that, not pushing too far in. I mean, the cartridge port, the pins look fine to me anyway, but I'll just do this as a matter of course while I've got the thing open. You don't want to use anything much thicker than a credit card, because you don't want to, force the pins. So, yeah, there's a lot of dirt on those pins. So let's just use the other corner quickly. I mean, you never know. Perhaps this wasn't reading games before. And if your Atari's not reading games, just doing something like this is a good idea. Yeah, so not much dirt on that side. So yeah, I'm happy that that cartridge port is as clean as it's gonna get. So let's put it all back together and hopefully I'll have a game to test with it. Okay, so I forgot to mention the bottom of the board. Bottom of the board, it's clean as well, apart from it looks like earwax. It's really not, I promise. There's a big sort of line of yellowy brown gunk, it looks like flux or something, on the rear. So I'm just cleaning that off. It's not the best sort of looking thing, so just getting it off. So I'm just getting a bit more isopropyl on a cotton bud. It's actually quite stubborn. It is coming off. It just takes a bit of going over. So I'm not sure what this is. I'm not sure if this is from the manufacturing process or it's something that's leaked in around the back, around the ports at some point. But it is coming. It is coming off. But it's just minging and looks like earwax. So I'll get the rest of that off and then we'll stick Pole Position in and hook it up to a TV via RF. Unfortunately, that's all this is outputting at the moment. And yeah, we'll hook up to the TV and see what sort of picture we get, if any. So yeah, join you in a minute. Okay, that's the console reassembled. And yeah, so this dates from 1986, not 83, as I said a while ago in the video. So still, for that age, it's not in bad condition. And I've decided to open up the joystick, and again everything looks fine inside. There's not much point cleaning these little contacts because they're under a layer of transparent plastic, so they're not going to be dirty or anything. I'm just going to put a bit of grease that part there, which goes into that little standoff there. Just going to put a little bit of grease in there because that's what the joystick swivels on. So yeah, apart from that, very simple, looks good. It might not work at all, but it looks to be in good nick. So I'll get this put back together, then we'll stick pole position in and let's see if we get anything on screen. Okay, so about 2 minutes after I finished filming, pole position just popped through the letterbox, and it doesn't look like that broken tab on the cartridge port over there is going to be much concern here, because it's one of these carts with the PCBs exposed. So I think those tabs are actually just for the ones that have got the little cover in place. This is a later cartridge from about the same time as the console, 1986. This is the red label re-release of pole position, so it's got a exposed PCB. So I've got everything plugged in, so we'll give it a test. So we'll just put the cartridge in like that and we'll turn on the power and see what happens. And it looks like we're in black and white. We're in black and white for some reason. But it's working. And the joystick. Seems to be working, not sure. So that's a reset. Now why is it black and white? This is a PAL game that's been tested. So it's likely something to do with the console. Perhaps the colour black and white switch is stuck on black and white. When I'm flicking it, nothing's happening. Strange. Well, perhaps this is an NTSC console, I don't know. I'll do a bit more research, and yeah, we'll have a little look into that. But please, at the moment, it actually works. That's one good thing. So yeah, let's see what I find out. And just as I stopped recording, the colour came back. That's a bit strange. Literally the second I stopped recording, the colour popped back on the screen. So it could be a case of faulty switch, dirty contacts on the cartridge, something like that. But no, it's we've got colour again. How strange. Let's just try reseating the cartridge. It could be a dirty contact or something. Yeah, we've got colour back. If we go black and white, nothing happens. So I wonder if the colour black and white switch is a bit faulty on this console. There we are, there's the cat. You only ever see its back end for some reason on this video, don't you? But joystick is working. You've got to give it a lot of force though, so I'm not sure if that's quite right. Now it is working. Yeah, so for £5 I'm happy with that. It's a bit of a lazy restore in that I've not had to do anything to it. Just a cosmetic job really. And there we are. So you can still get cheap consoles on eBay. So I'll fix that tab on the cartridge slot as and when I need to for a game that, you know, requires it. But otherwise, stuff like this, yeah, fine. I'm gonna play myself some pole position now. Okay, so yeah, I hope you just enjoyed this quick little lazy restoration. One last thing to do. I nearly forgot. Let's get ourselves unplugged. Let's get in a bit better light. And let's peel. Let's peel a plastic film off. Oh, there we go. There, it's a moment to treasure. Wow, that's got some shine to it. Bit of discoloration at this end, or a bit of somewhere I've got under the film where it's a bit bubbly, but that might clean off. Wow, yeah. So that's nice. That's one of the reasons I bought it, because I had that film on it. Good stuff. Yeah, so very pleased with that. Hope you've enjoyed this little lazy restore. Didn't take long at all. Atari 2600 Junior. Alright then, thanks for watching, guys. Okay, so I thought I'd just do a little update. I've been playing Pole Position and it's playing just fine. I've been using the Sega Master System pad and the original joypad, and actually, I know I said I didn't really get on with these pads. These joysticks. It's actually not that bad. I mean, it's a bit unresponsive, but then again, the games are simple. So yeah, I was going to just sell this on, really, but I think I might keep it with it because they just make a nice couple, don't they? I mean, I thought this was all joysticks were good for, and I've got one there mounted on my cupboard door as a coat hook. That's a Cheetah 125 there. Stuck in there with a goat hook, and all the internals removed. The buttons obviously don't move anymore, and it's just mounted on two screws. And with these little notches, it does make a good little coat hook. So yeah, this one will not end up like that. I'll keep that, chew marks and all. So yeah, very pleased. It's working fine now. Colour every time. Not bad at all. Lovely and shiny. Right, so yeah, that was my impatient restoration, because I've really got no patience to be tinkering with consoles too much. I just enjoy cleaning them, and I like it when this happens, when it's all it needs a bit of a clean, and then you're away. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys.